Championship Wrestling. Innovators in televised wrestling of personality profiles. Split screen, instant replay first. The program voted number one by the Wrestling Writers Federation of America. Join us now for the fast-paced competition of professional wrestling, featuring the top grapplers from the world's largest governing body, the National Wrestling Alliance.
Charlotte, along with Les Thatcher, welcome to Southeastern Championship Wrestling, another innovation by Southeastern Wrestling President Don Curtis. Today starts Championship Month, Les.
That's right, and the first title defended here on television, Charlotte, will be the Alabama state title held by Mr. Saito, who will be going against Bob Armstrong.
Also in action today, you'll see former North American heavyweight champion Paul Orndorff in action against Oki Shikina.
Outlaw Ron Bass takes on Robert Gibson.
And Jimmy Golden takes on Ray Harris. A lot of action, a lot of news taking place in the Southeastern wrestling area. And with Championship Month, it brings to mind a lot of things that are happening with titles here in the area.
That's right. Within a matter of 5 days, Jerry Stubbs defeated Les Thornton for the World Junior Heavyweight title. And in the first return bout, Thornton was able to edge Stubbs. And, of course, this shocked the entire wrestling world. Jerry Stubbs is out to regain that title. We'll be talking to Steve about that later on, Charlie.
Another shock to the wrestling world was the incident taking place between Jimmy Golden and the Tennessee stud Ron Fuller. This week in Knoxville, Tennessee, we were able to talk with the Tennessee stud Ron Fuller, and an unexpected development took place there last he vacated the Southeastern Heavyweight Championship. Right after a doctor's checkup, we had a chance to talk to Ron Fuller in Knoxville.
Well, Charlie, I do have a lot of things on my mind. First of all, I just got some stitches taken out of my head yesterday from the altercation with Jimmy Golden, and I just got through seeing a neck specialist here that I've seen several times over the past few years. I've got a bad neck problem. I've always had a bad neck problem, and he's advised me that I shouldn't wrestle for at least 3 or 4 weeks. But in this sport, athletes normally get well a lot quicker than the average person does, and I think that I'll be back in the ring in the next couple of weeks or so. However, I do want to, the reason that I called y'all to come to Tennessee is this has been a very tough time for me the last month, 5, 6 weeks in my life. I had the problem with John Valiant, who I brought from New York, who I didn't know very well, and it was to be expected that man would possibly turn on me. But this thing with Jimmy Golden is really more than physically hurting my body, and it's been a real mental torment to me, Charlie. I really thought that I could trust Jimmy Golden. I guess I was a real fool to think so, and my brother told me so, and I guess he was absolutely right about it. Well, the reason I called you up here is, like I said, I'm not supposed to compete in the ring for the next month at least, the doctor tells me, but I'm going to be wrestling again very soon, but I'm not going to wrestle in the Southeastern area anymore. I've given this a lot of thought. I feel like that I have been humiliated in this part of the country by the things that's happened to me, especially over this incident with Jimmy Golden. And what I called you up here for is to tell you and to tell the people there in that part of the country that they've all been very fine to me, and I really have enjoyed it. I love that part of the country, but I don't want to compete there anymore. I don't want to be around Jimmy Golden. I don't want to be around the humiliation that I've really suffered there in the past 5 or 6 weeks. And what I want to do, Charlie, is I brought this belt. I knew you were going to be here today, and I'm vacating the Southeastern Championship. I would certainly like the title shot with Harley Race, and I know that there's some tremendous wrestlers in the southeastern part of the United States right now. I know that there's going to be some fine competitors that lay his hands on this belt, and he may be the next world heavyweight champion. But at this point in time in my life, I don't have the heart, the desire, I don't have the peace of mind, I don't have the things necessary to compete like a man should anymore, and that thing has been very, very personally is one of the finest things that I've ever owned is a Southeastern belt, and I do hate to give it up, but I cannot in good faith come back to the Southeastern United States and compete, and that's it.
There you see the incident taking place. It's certainly surprising that Ron Fuller surrendered the Southeastern title, but when you get to thinking about the family aspect that's involved with cousin Jimmy Golden, there's a lot of problems.
I was about to say, Charlie, I don't think it's a case of Ron's running away, walking away, whatever. Certainly a lot of men are in aggravation. I can appreciate that. This is a sport that I've always been kind of a competitor as a wrestling commentator. But what's happened needs a little time, I guess, for Ron to clear it out of his mind. It's not the body that's bothering him. It's a mental thing. And I can appreciate that. And I wish Ron the best of luck.
Well, that's all I can say is with the incident and with the comments of Ron, best wishes to the Tennessee Stud, Ron Fuller, an outstanding athlete in pro wrestling. Let's go to the ring now, the election of our first match of the day.
Our first match, one fall, 10-minute time limit, the referee, Tommy Weathers. Tommy Weathers, introducing in the corner to my left, at 235 pounds, from Tampa, Florida, Paul Orndorff. Paul Orndorff. His opponent, at 240 pounds, from Japan, the Japanese destroyer, Shikina.
Shikina taking on former North American heavyweight champion, Paul Orndorff, who, in his short time here in the Southeastern wrestling area, has gained the support of all the wrestling fans, and rightfully so.
Yes, he has. Paul has created quite a stir among the wrestlers themselves. He and Norvell Austin have done well in tag team action. Paul in singles action has been very productive. And certainly, I think this young man will be hurt a lot from physically in that wrestling ring. He's a hard man to handle.
Shikina on the move now. Orndorff, and it's Orndorff dropping that elbow, coming up with the arm bar on Oki Shikina. In case you're just joining us, it's championship month.
Yes, it is. Saito against Armstrong for the Alabama state title coming up in the program. We might look at that situation. Paul was trying to go over the top of Shikina as he saw him coming back. Shikina pulling up short, lost his balance. Paul going backwards toward him, and down went Shikina, which Oki thought he was going to pull one out of the fire on Paul there, but it backfired on Oki.
Arm twist by Paul Orndorff, and again applying that pressure. Shikina with a shortcut, takedown by the hair, but Orndorff right back to his feet.
Shikina with that shot to the throat, cutting the wind off the air supply, and goes to work on Orndorff. Veteran campaigner, Oki Shikina, a hard man to handle. He'll give you a fight any time you face him. And right now, Paul Orndorff is incurring his wrath. A chop to the forehead, a jab in up under the chin, and by referee Tommy Weathers. Orndorff blasts back at second right and a third. Paul Orndorff grabs the headlock, Charlie. Right on his feet.
Yeah. And with a drop kick. Orndorff crashing down with that knee into the chest area. Takes his man back into the rope. Ah,
Orndorff on the move. What's he going for here? The suplex. Drop kick, Nina.
And your winner, former North American heavyweight champion, Paul Orndorff. On championship month here at Southeastern Championship Wrestling. Great win for Paul Orndorff. And speaking of champions, Paul Orndorff has been in pursuit along with his tag team partner, Norvell Austin. They're after the Southeastern tag titles held by Rosenton.
That's right. Randy Rosen will walk right in front of our camera for us now. And he and Dennis Conner are going to join us to look at a film of them against Orndorff and Austin, and the titles were at stake, Charlie.
Yeah, go ahead and show us the film here. Show us how they threw away the rule book. Show us how they abided by no rules whatsoever.
And here we see videotaped highlights of a match in which Austin and Orndorff went after your Southeastern tag titles.
You know, it's gotten to the point, Charlie Clash. When we come out here, we try to wrestle, we try to abide by the rules. All these people over here love us. All these people out here watching love us. We try our best. But the first person that throws punches, the first person that throws us over the rope, seems to be Orndorff and Austin. And they're coming out here trying to reverse all kinds of decisions, knowing that they're in the wrong and we're in the right. Like we said, there's a conspiracy of bias against Rose and Condrey in this area.
Let's watch this tape. I think it'll speak for itself in this particular situation. There you are diverting the attention of the referee.
You know, Mr. Platt, the only thing we ask for in a contest
is that the referee call it right down the middle. That's all we ask for, because we are scientific wrestlers, and we do abide by the rules. Now, all we ask is for the referees in the southeastern area to just call it like you see it, baby. Just call it right down the middle. See, here, I'm on the top rope. I started to jump off, and I said, no, I'm not going to do it. That's against the rules. I'm not going to do nothing against the rules.
Strictly by the rules. My courage was up there, and he said, no. Nope. He said, no, I'm going to go by the rules. We're starting to go by the rules now. That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to stick to it, me and my Cosmo.
I think the tape takes care of explaining everything if you're abiding by the rules too long.
Well,
on
the second rope is not against the rules. Off the top is against the rules. The second rope is not against the rules.
If you realize the ropes are there, Charlie. If they wasn't, they're there for a reason. We use a rope. We use every wrestling hole. We use everything we know. They are there for a reason.
That is the top rope you're coming off.
No, my left foot was
on the
second
rope. And
rope.
That is a disqualification.
No, I was coming strictly off the
that
second
is
rope.
That is the top rope you came off of, and that was
you know, I didn't remember my cousin doing that. That must be some kind of trick photography or something.
Yeah,
my
no
cousin
trick
did not come off the top rope like you just saw.
I think like you just saw, he did come off the top rope, and that is a disqualification automatically.
Well, here we had a little misunderstanding here. The match is over at this point. It's already over, huh?
And the match goes to Paul Orndorff and Norvell Austin. On the disqualification, you coming off, Randy Rose coming off of that top.
You know, the referee, all we want is the referee to call it right down the middle. That's all we ask for.
You know, we got plenty of glasses, and the referee, I think he needs some because I was not on the top rope. And you need to have your check
possible. Coming off the top rope, automatic disqualification, and it could be a way to hold on to titles for the Southeastern Tag Champion. We'll be back with more action on Southeastern Wrestling in just a moment.
Call 320-6163. Tickets on sale at the Boutwell box office Monday at 9 a.m. In the main event, a challenge match. Ken Lucas returns to action to battle Jimmy Golden. The new Southeastern Heavyweight Champion, Outlaw Ron Bass, defends against Paul Orndorff in a special event. Six-man tag team action. Bob and Brad Armstrong team with Norvell Austin to take on the trio of Mr. Saito, Randy Rose, and Dennis Condrey. Women's liberation comes to professional wrestling. It's women versus men as Joyce Grable and Judy Martin meet Roy Welch and Robert Gibson. Jerry Stubbs takes on Tom Horn. And Ron Slinker opens against Okie Shikina. Don't forget Ken Lucas against Jimmy Golden. Ron Bass against Paul Orndorff. The Armstrongs and Austin against Saito, Rose, and Condrey. And women's liberation match. Joyce Grable and Judy Martin take on Roy Welch and Robert Gibson. It all comes together Monday night, Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium. We'd like to remind you fans, there is no wrestling here on Channel 42 next week. But wrestling returns on Saturday, February the 21st at 2 p.m. No wrestling next Saturday, February the 21st. Wrestling returns at 2 p.m. A super lineup. Women against men Monday night in Boutwell's Auditorium. Plus, the new Southeastern Heavyweight Champion, Ron Bass, puts his title on the line against Paul Orndorff. Before I talk to the champion, let's hear from the challenger.
You know, Bass, I hope you're out there somewhere listening to what I got to say, because there's no love lost between us. We have met before in the middle of that ring, and I used to respect you as a person and as a wrestler. But anybody that deliberately tries to put another man out of what makes him a living can't be much of a man. You can't be gutless, because when I step in that ring with you, Bass, me and you are going to go at it, tooth and nail. I don't care. If you want to wrestle, we'll wrestle. If you want to fight, we'll fight. But I'm coming after that belt. Because that belt means a lot. It means a shot at the world's heavyweight champion. And that's what I'm going for. I'm going for your belt, and I'm going to be the next world champion.
You've got a determined challenger. Your title's on the line for the first time in Birmingham, right?
The man's crying about Ricky Gibson again. Well, I'm going to tell you something, Orndorff. That's over. The man's hurt. He's done. He's gone. And you've got to be a man to stay in this wrestling business. And that's what I am, Paul Orndorff. Now, let's talk about this title just a minute, Les. You know as well as I do that Harley Race, the world's champion, will be here in less than a month away. And whoever's holding this title right here is going to get a chance at that world's championship. That's something that we're all striving for. That's something we all dream of. And Paul Orndorff, you're right. I have met you before, and you didn't like that outcome at all, did you, boy? Well, I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to like it Monday night even less. Because when I get you in Boutwell, I've got something to prove to myself, and I got something to prove to the fans, the promotion, that I'm going to be the man that wrestles Harley Race. I'm going to hold this title and be the man.
Monday night, Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium, a super lineup. Women against men, the Southeastern title at stake.
a gray ray of stars you won't want to miss.
Join me now, three champions in their own right, Dennis Condrey and Randy Rose, the Southeastern Tag Champions, and Mr. Saito, the Alabama State Heavyweight Champion. Mr. Saito will be defending his title today on television against Bob Armstrong as a part of Championship Month, here the month of February, at Southeastern Championship Wrestling.
So today, Bob Armstrong, you know, I beat so easy, you're too soft, you karate too soft. You know, American karate, the disco dance. Today, I beat the hell out of you. You know my name. You retire. You stay home. Eat popcorn, watch TV. Your family take care of you.
Something else that you three men are joining in a venture into six-man tag action, and the Southeastern Tag Champions will be teaming with the Alabama State Champions.
You know, you're just surrounded by champions on each side and then behind you.
First of all,
the Southeastern champions, Condrey and Rose, to each side, the Alabama champion behind you, baby. You're surrounded by them, brother.
First of all, you're lucky for us to adorn our presence to you and these people here watching this TV. You're lucky to have the champions. And the queen says, we are champions. And we will remain champions. TV, it don't matter, like the man says, all of you can go home, eat popcorn, watch TV.
Let me remind you, there's some outstanding competitors like Paul Orndorff, Ken Lucas, and others.
They may be outstanding to you, but to us, they're just another doormat to walk across. Because we got the belt, and we're going to keep it.
You'll be seeing them in six-man tag action, the Southeastern Tag Champions, Rose and Condrey, and the Alabama State Heavyweight Champion, Mr. Saito.
Next match, one fall, 10 minutes time limit, the referee, Larry Brock. Larry Brock, your referee. Introducing, in the corner to my left, at 218 pounds from Pensacola, Florida, Robert Gibson.
Hey, kid, you've been lucky a couple of times. So far, I haven't been able to get to that leg and put you out like your brother, but right here on TV, it's going to happen, boy.
Pounds from Tampa, Texas, Ron Bass. Ron Bass.
Ron Bass out against Robert Gibson. And going in low, Bass low, trying for the leg. Robert Gibson dancing away.
Side headlock by Gibson.
Robert must have been looking at the cowboy hat when he mentioned the champion. Thinking he was talking about the Tennessee Stud.
Side headlock by Robert Gibson.
Just to apply that pressure. Of course, Robert's spotting about 65 pounds in this one, but he's got a lot of speed. Charlie, lots of burn, and Bass going to have to tie him down to keep him on that canvas. But control it. And the leg certainly seems quite a battering there as Bass moves in. He's mentioning Ricky Gibson's knee and leg just before the bout started. You can see Bass now concentrating on the left leg of Robert Gibson. Referee Larry Brock warning Bass.
Come on, Gibson. Don't be so far.
Find that pressure, Charlie, and lean back on it. That power, as he said, he's going to have to keep Gibson down to control him. And right now, he has got 1 point of the 5 points of balance. That's what professional wrestling is all about, and he's concentrating on that left leg.
Still going in full force. He has Gibson over in the corner. Brock trying to break it up. He does. Bass not giving Robert any breathing room whatsoever.
Bass Presley got the advantage. He intends to hang on to it, but Robert Gibson battling back now. A couple well-placed elbows. Straightens the man from Tampa, Texas up. Gibson, who can cross corner, moves in and is hit over that top rope.
Over the top rope. Automatic disqualification.
All the weight went down on that leg, Charlie, as Robert hit, trying to break his fall.
This match is over as far as Robert Gibson would be the winner. Now he's pushing down the official. Robert Gibson trying to get out of the ring. The winner of the match, Robert Gibson, with the over-the-top rope disqualification. Coming up, our personality profile, and then after the profile, what begins championship month. Mr. Saito will defend the Alabama State Heavyweight Championship against Bob Armstrong. Stay with us.
Profile segment of Southeastern Championship Wrestling. My guests today, Robert Gibson and Roy Welch. And our topic of discussion is women's liberation matches in pro wrestling, Roy.
It's something that has taken place here in the Southeastern area. I've only known it to take place one time previous to these matches being booked, and that was in Atlanta, Georgia. Backtracking the situation, Joyce Grable and Judy Martin called Don Curtis, the president of Southeastern Championship Wrestling, requesting a match against men.
You know, Charlie, it had to come. They've come into every sport so far, so it had to come to professional wrestling.
They specifically indicated that they would like junior heavyweights in the ring as their opponents. Now, you and Robert, I know you commented to me by telephone during the week when all of this took place that you thought Curtis was really joking with you to start with about actually competing against a woman in the ring.
Well, my first impression sure was, Charlie, because it's different in professional wrestling, unlike other sports. You talk about tennis or you talk about golf. It's not a contact type of sport. We're talking about lady wrestlers. But after talking to them a while, I realized that it's not so far-fetched because these are professionally trained athletes. They've gone through the same rigorous training that we had to go through when we first started. They go through very heavy endurance training as well as wrestling training. So we're not talking about just any two women off the street. We're talking about two top professional wrestling wrestlers. And they are the tops in their line, by the way, being a former world tag team champions. To them, that's probably as far as they can go. So what's left for them, I guess, would be to challenge a man and try to defeat him.
Robert, what was your first impression when you were notified that you had been booked against Joyce Grable and Judy Martin and Roy Welch as your partner?
I'm like Roy Lee. I thought it was a joke at first. I kind of had a little grin on my face, but like Roy said, these ladies used to be the world tag team champions, and I've never wrestled a girl or ever had anything to do with a girl physical like that, but I'm like Roy. You got to see what happens.
And I must say, Don Curtis has been fair in booking this match, you two junior heavyweights. Joyce Grable and Judy Martin will not have one chance in the ring against men in competition, but this is an event that Don has booked in towns like Mobile, Pensacola, Montgomery, and Birmingham. They'll have more than one chance.
Well, they're probably going to need more than one chance because to get in with us for the first time is going to be quite different from anything they've done. So I think that it'll take a couple of times for us to really be able to get the feel of being in there against a professional male wrestler.
Well, the news of this women's lib matches has certainly got the world of professional wrestling buzzing, especially to wrestlers not only in this area but all across the country. Let's hear now some comments about this particular match from Bob and Brad Armstrong. Joining them as Les Factor.
Well, of course, a lot of new things happen in professional wrestling over our careers, Bob, but this is probably one of the most unique. And I know Charlie was mentioning that there, a match like this had taken place in Atlanta, Georgia. You did see that match.
I did see that match, and it was a very competitive match. The lady wrestler surprised me terrifically. Pardon me, but it was the same two lady wrestlers that had called on Curtis and challenged Roy Welch and the Gibson man. So, you know, it's women against men, but like everybody said, they've done it in all other sports. Don Curtis likes to bring new type of matches. He gives away a lot of money. He does a lot of innovative things in the Southeastern area. So I'm very proud and happy that it's here because I wouldn't miss it for the world. I don't envy their position. I wouldn't be in that position for anything in the world. But these men didn't ask for this match. They were challenged, and they accepted the challenge. Now, Don Curtis is not just going to have this in one town. He's going to have it in Pensacola, Mobile, Montgomery, Birmingham, and all the major cities in the Southeastern area. They'll get to see two men wrestle two women. And these two women, like we've heard, are not just two women. They're former world tag team champions. They've been in Korea. They've been in New Zealand, Australia, Japan, and they're undefeated overseas. So, you know, you're talking about a tag team match. Now, when one man happens to stray in the corner of two ladies, that's two wildcats on you, brother. Anything can happen then, so I can't wait to see it myself.
Well, of course, stamina and strength has something to do with it, and then they have a little advantage there. But in the tag team match, the women will get a little rest as they tag out. Brad, you're relatively new to the sport of professional wrestling. You've held the tag team belts with your father, currently holding the U.S. Junior title. How would you go about wrestling a lady if you had to defend your title against her?
Tell you the truth, I love to wrestle ladies, but I've never wrestled one that's actually tried to beat me. So it's definitely going to be different.
It's a mental handicap, Bob, if it's nothing else.
Exactly right, but you got to remember, they're professionals. They've been slammed, they've been bumped, they've been bruised, they've been thrown over the top rope, dropped on their head. They've had it all done to them, just like the men, so it'll be very interesting.
The comments and opinions of Bob and Brad Armstrong. Back to you, Charlie.
Certainly, I have to agree with Bob Armstrong. I do not envy you two gentlemen at all, because strategy planning in this situation would be tough.
Well, we just got to see what comes out the first time we go against the ladies. But one thing for sure, if these two lady wrestlers have the guts to come out and challenge a male professional wrestler, then I say let's give them a chance. I'm anxious for the match, right?
I'm looking forward to seeing the match myself. Best of luck to you two gentlemen, Robert Gibson and Roy Welch, in the women's rib match against former ladies tag team champions Joyce Grable and Judy Martin. It's something new, and it's taking place right here in the Southeastern wrestling area.
Championship month there on television. The first title to be defended will be the Alabama state title, and the man challenging for that formerly held the championship, Bob Armstrong.
You're absolutely right, and my opponent is Mr. Saito, the man with a Japanese sleeper. But today, you know, I got a little cobra hole myself. Somebody's going to get hurt here on TV today. It'll either be him or me. It's come down to this right here live on TV. I'm proud to be a part of it, and I want to be the Alabama champion.
The comments from the challenger, now Charlie Platt with the champion.
You will defend that title, Mr. Saito, against former champion Bob Armstrong today.
But he's trying to recover the fall. He can. Look at my neck. 22 inches. My picture, my big arms. I'm so Japanese. Today, I put sleeper hold you. You're sleepy. That's it. You're free.
It'll be interesting, the outcome of the state
championship match, as Mr. Saito defends against former champion Bob Armstrong. Let's go to the ring now with Al Roberts for the introduction of the match.
This is an Alabama state championship match. Introducing the challenger in the corner to my left at 228 pounds from Marietta, Georgia, Bob Armstrong. Armstrong. The champion at 245 pounds from Tokyo, Japan, Mr. Saito. Saito.
And no doubt on who the crowd favorite is here, Bob Armstrong, taking on Saito. It's the first championship match of championship month.
Exactly, Charlie. The Alabama State Islanders take the champion, Mr. Saito. Bob Armstrong, the challenger. Nice leg kick taken down by Saito. Armstrong hooks him, takes him over. Men have met before. No love lost here. A volatile situation. We've got it here on television. Championship month. Armstrong with the wrist lock takedown into the Saito right back up. And of course, not as it only catches catch stand style wrestling, but focus then. First of the martial arts. Saito feels that Armstrong's a disco dancer. And John Travolta, look out, because if this is disco, you're out of your league.
Saito with the front chancery. Armstrong trying to move his way out. That's where that strength in those arms come in handy right now, Les.
We can't forget the strength in the grip of Mr. Saito. Both men using a version of sleeper. And Armstrong right now with the armbar applying the pressure. Saito, a man built like a fire plug, a hard one to handle with a lot of power. Good leg trip. Trapped that left leg, but Armstrong using the right leg. Comes down with a guillotine-like blow across the head of Saito.
Side headlock with takedown. Head scissors by arms. Say what I've noticed on defense for Bob Armstrong. He's not giving Saito any chance to grab hold of that grip.
Both ways here, Charlie. I was just about to say, neither man has settled down with his offense yet. Both men moving fast, moving well. And, of course, television time much shorter than a normal hour time limit in a heavyweight championship match. So the challenger is put in a position he's got to go and go quick. Saito is not just defensing. He's moving in. He's really aggressive as well. Nice fireman carry takedown into the armbar. And the man from Japan in control in the driver's seat now. He hangs onto the arm of Bob Armstrong.
Bob Armstrong looking for some means of escape.
Most definitely Armstrong has that speed going for him. Both men have similar submission holds, finishing holds, whatever you want to call them. The sleeper, right now it is the power. The Japanese fire plug, Mr. Saito, controlling offensively. Armstrong breaks free, comes up, hooks his man, and right out is the Japanese gentleman. Collar and elbow. No. Armstrong grabs the head. Saito in low with the waist lock now. Saito, when it surprised me, went in awfully low, and he has arms up. Applying that pressure.
Saito. Looking to hold Armstrong in. There again, Les, both men moving quickly.
And leg sweep. Saito in good stead three times throughout this contest so far. The chop by the champion again.
But Armstrong fires back. Bob Armstrong firing it again against the Alabama State heavyweight champion. This is championship match. The ring official in the way of action. And Larry Brock is knocked down. Armstrong out of the ring.
He tried to sit on that second rope, lost his balance, and fell through. He was dazed. And look here. He's blocking the chop attempt by Saito. Armstrong goes for his sleeper. Yes, Condrey with a board over the head of Bob Armstrong. That board splintered, Charlie. You could hear the thud over here, and the board splintered. Armstrong is out. No doubt about that. And Saito applies the Japanese sleeper. You can see him gripping in at that carotid artery. And Larry Brock on the way. Wait a minute. Senior referee Tommy Weathers moves in to put a stop to this. What's this call going to be? Orndorff, Brad Armstrong, Ray Harris, Norvell, Austin all jump into the ring. Saito's gone. Bob Armstrong is unconscious, Charlie. He was nailed good to that board, and the board was splintered.
Here comes the senior referee in the Southeastern area. I'm taking it on my own to hold this belt up. I'm not going to sit back and watch something happen.
Oh, the official decision. I see you at least on the others. He's overruled Larry Brock's decision and is holding the bell up, Charlie, at this particular point. And I think it's the right decision on Tommy's part.
Indeed, and we'll be back with more action on Southeastern Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
No wrestling next week here on Channel 42, but Southeastern Wrestling returns Saturday, February the 21st at 2 p.m. No wrestling next Saturday, returning on Saturday, February 21st at 2 p.m. Super lineup, Monday night in Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium. Women against the men, among other things, a Southeastern heavyweight title match and a six-man tag team match. Bob and Brad Armstrong team with Norvell Austin to take on the trio of Mr. Saito, Randy Rose, and Dennis Condrey. Before I talk to the Armstrongs and Austin, let's hear from their opponents.
Look at us, boys. Three champions standing here. The Alabama State champion and the Southeastern tag team champions against nobody. Let me say this. I'm going to make it quick and straight to the point. Boys, you can't beat us. There's no way. No three men walking the face of the earth can beat this combination in a tag team match.
Well, certainly, Bob, they seem to think they've got it all one cut and dry.
Well, and they're calling us nobodies, too. But, you know, when they leave Boutwell Auditorium, they might be calling us somebody. The somebodies that beat all the champions. People that say that nobody on the face of the earth can beat them make mistakes just like anybody else. And when we get to Birmingham, we've got to be considered the underdogs. Brad goes about 205, I'm about 228, Norvell weighs about the same. We're outweighed probably a couple of hundred pounds. But, you know, they don't measure a man by the size of him. They measure a man by the size of his intestinal fortitude. And we got a lot to prove because every time we try to wrestle, we've got interference from either Condrey and Rose or Saito. We've got them bunched. We've got them bunched in Birmingham. And the big bunch is going down in Birmingham. Six ways, brother, six-man tag. Anything can happen and probably will in Birmingham.
Norvell, you've had your differences with Rose and Condrey. You've got two good partners to back you up on Monday night.
Exactly right. I'm proud to have these two guys as partners, and we're going to go out there cooking and smoking better. So get yourself ready. We're going to get some consolation out of this match. We ain't got no best, so we're going to get some consolation by beating y'all 1-2-3.
Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium, 8 p.m. Monday night. You won't want to miss it.
Our next match, one fall TV time remaining. Introducing in the corner to my left, at 218 pounds from Dothan, Alabama, Ray Harris. Ray Harris, his opponent at 232 pounds from Montgomery, Alabama, Jimmy Golden. Jimmy Golden.
Well, Thrasher, what has happened here, I'm sure, will be dealt with John Curtis and others.
That's right. Senior referee Tommy Weathers has given me the belt. It has been held up. I just checked the dressing room. Bob Armstrong is groggy. Get a good lick with that board, and he's trying to pull the cobwebs down, but I believe he's going to be all right, Charlie. All right now, Jimmy Golden in that ring, being questioned by Tommy Weathers about his tactics, collar and elbow, Ray Harris, Jimmy Golden. And Jimmy Golden has said he's going to be the cock of the walk in the Southeastern. He's going to be the new living legend, and he'll take on anyone that says differently. Ray Harris crashing headfirst into that turnbuckle. Golden takes him in. Throws that looping little right hand in up under the chin. He can cross ring and catch him with a kick to the midsection. Ray Harris opens strong, but Golden, a tough veteran, taking over control offensively and is having things his own way. Going to the nerve hole, the trapezius area, around the neck. And of course, Charlie, after this match, we're going to have Jimmy Golden over here at the desk to talk to him and take a look at the match he had with Mr. Wrestling Number 2.
Mr. Wrestling Number 2, living legend in pro wrestling, outstanding competitor. And, as you say, we'll be reviewing that videotape of Golden versus Wrestling 2. This is our first week of championship week. Next week, more titles will be defended here on television. And with that little event taking place a few moments ago, there is no Alabama State heavyweight champion.
Golden with Harris trapped in that corner, working him over. Good body slam. Golden going for the elbow. Harris out of the way. Good move by Ray Harris. Jimmy Golden dropping that elbow, but there was nothing but the mat to drop it on. Harris may be back in this one, Charlie. Has a fresh start here. Moves in on Golden in that corner. Again, working him over. Harris with a small package. Golden up and out. Harris moving in again. Headlock now. Golden shoots him off. Harris with a nice roll-up. And again. Near pin. Golden got him across the face, able to break out. Ray Beals, his man, going for the drop kick, and has him curled up well on that drop kick. He hit him with a lot of force. Jimmy coming up slowly. Golden with a side headlock.
Harris takes his man into the rope, drops down, coming up. And there we see.
Wait for that drop kick, Charlie. He missed it. Jimmy grabbed the rope. He anticipated the move. Reverse neck breaker, Jimmy Golden's trademark, and he may have it here.
It's over. And the winner of the match is Jimmy Golden. And certainly we've seen a lot of action today on Southeastern Wrestling. There's more coming up because right now we would like to take you into the arenas of Southeastern Championship Wrestling for a match in which Golden takes on a living legend, Mr. Wrestling number 2, if we could roll that tape now.
And he is gone bye-bye.
There is no more legend wrestling Mr. 2. He went down in defeat in Dothan, Alabama by the hands of Jimmy Golden. And I understand that the Tennessee Stud has put up his title. He is ready to go, and he's not coming back to the fair because he's a coward. He's afraid of Jimmy Golden.
That's when Jimmy was side headlock. Wrestling 2 seems to have things well under control at this point of the match.
Johnny, they're coming from all four corners of the world, brother, to face the superstar Jimmy Golden. Wrestling number 2, Robert Fuller, Tony Atlas, Ron Slinker, and there's supposed to be a surprise opponent by the name of Ken Lucas. Lucas, you ain't no surprise, geek. You're mud, boy. You ain't nothing but mud. I'm going to be the legend. It's one legend there. Went down in defeat. Last week, another legend's going to go down in defeat. This week, I'm going to be the legend in this area.
You're hearing those of Jimmy Golden. And here we see Jimmy taking on Wrestling 2.
Did you see that man begging for mercy out there, Charlie Platt? Big, tough wrestler. Wrestling number 2.
Two count on wrestling, by Wrestling 2 on Jimmy Golden.
He's no 3 count, though, baby. He never will get a 3 count on Jimmy Golden. He was begging for mercy. He was begging to please not to hit him no more. Begging me, please don't pull my mask off and show my ugly face to everybody. I just almost certainly took it off of him anyway.
Right there you see Mr. Wrestler number 2 was using illegal fists, hitting me in the throat, and the eyes kicking me in the face. But he's going to get a little taste of his own medicine, baby. He's going to get a little taste of his own medicine. He's going to get beat real good. You call that legal wrestling, yeah? You see him punch me in the gut?
There's that famous high knee lift. They go into the canvas, famous. You go outside of the
famous
ring.
Famous mop foot.
And I think right here is where you'll
see. Look at this.
Outside
the ring, man. He's supposed to, the referee's supposed to be counting.
What are you doing in your knee pad? There you have some object coming out of the knee
nothing,
pad.
Nothing, man. There wasn't nothing in my knee pad. Now he's trying to suplex me back into the ring.
You hit him.
I hit him with a good
object.
Right cross,
you hit
brother.
Him with some object.
And down he went. He's out. He don't see nothing now but stars, brother. He's looking at stars right now. Yeah, he reminds me of that Tennessee Stud with that mask on. 1, 2, and 3. There's your living legend, Wrestling 2. There's supposed to be another one by the name of Ken Lucas. That's supposed to be a legend. I'm going to be your legend, ladies and gentlemen. Ain't nobody going to do it but Jimmy Golden. I'm going to be your legend. The superstars have all gone.
Ken Lucas has come out here. Let's get out of this. Get out of this.
Southeastern Wrestling Card. For reservations and information, call 320-6163. Tickets on sale at the Boutwell Box Office Monday at 9 a.m. In the main event, a challenge match. Ken Lucas returns to action to battle Jimmy Golden. The new Southeastern Heavyweight Champion, Outlaw Ron Bass, defends against Paul Orndorff in a special event. Six-man tag team action. Bob and Brad Armstrong team with Norvell Austin to take on the trio of Mr. Saito, Randy Rose, and Dennis Condrey. Women's liberation comes to professional wrestling. It's women versus men as Joyce Grable and Judy Martin meet Roy Welch and Robert Gibson. Jerry Stubbs takes on Tom Horn. And Ron Slinker opens against Okie Shikina. Don't forget, Ken Lucas against Jimmy Golden. Ron Bass against Paul Orndorff. The Armstrongs and Austin against Saito, Rose and Condrey. And women's liberation match, Joyce Grable and Judy Martin take on Roy Welch and Robert Gibson. It all comes together Monday night, Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium.
Last reminder, no Southeastern Wrestling here on Channel 42 next Saturday. Southeastern Wrestling returns Saturday, February the 21st at 2 p.m. And a super lineup Monday night in Boutwell Auditorium, women against the men for the very first time in this area, plus the return of Ken Lucas as he goes against Jimmy Golden in a special challenge match. Before I talk to Kenny, let's hear from Jimmy Golden.
Ken Lucas, let me tell you something, boy. The day that you come out here and slap me in the face and get by with it is going to be the day, I'm going to tell you that. Who do you think you are, Mr. High and Mighty? You supposed to be this, and you supposed to be that, and you whipped everybody down here for years. Well, let me tell you something now, baby. You against the real thing now, brother, and we're going to get it on right in the middle of that little wrestling ring, and I'm going to clean house with your hind end, boy. Let me tell you something. I have beat the superstar, Ron Fuller, his punk brother, Robert Fuller, Mr. Tony Atlas, USA, Mr. Wrestling number two. I've cleaned house with all of them, baby, and you're going to be next, son. You ain't slapping me in the face and getting by with it. Get ready to get your hind end kicked good.
Well, Kenny, what do you think about that?
Well, you know, Les, in this profession, a lot of things can happen, you know, and he put a very good friend of mine out of commission, Mr. Ron Fuller, at Tennessee Stud. And I used to have a lot of respect for Mr. Golden, but anymore from the way I see he acts and the way I see he does. And he said that I did slap him. I did slap him, and I slapped him real good, and I got his attention real good, and that's just what I wanted to do. Because one thing for sure, Jimmy, let me tell you something. You get nothing for free in this country today. You have to work for everything you get. And let me say one thing, Jimmy. I'm coming to Birmingham with one thing in my mind, and that's to hurt you any way I can. And if I've got to do it that way, Jim, I'm sorry, but that's the way it goes, because I'm going to beat you, and I'm going to beat you from one inch of your life.
Ken Lucas returns to Birmingham to take on Jimmy Golden. It's the women against the men, Joyce Grable and Judy Martin, against Robert Gibson and Roy Welch, plus a great array of wrestling stars. Monday night, Birmingham's Boutwell Auditorium, bell time, 8 p.m. You'll want to be there.
Closing moments of Southeastern Championship Wrestling today. Let us say that a great turn of events. I see some of the wrestlers leaving the studio now. Bob Armstrong, what's his condition?
Well, Bob is going to be all right. Of course, he got a good blow with that board, and he's woozy, but Bob's going to be all right. But we started championship week off with a bang, literally, as well as figuratively, Charlie, because Tommy Weathers has held up this Alabama state title at this particular point.
Yes,
I think it was a wise decision. So, a lot of exciting things happen. Actually, we'll have a title match on the program again next week because February is championship month here at Southeastern Wrestling. Coming to the area, buying young competitors, Stanley and Wayne, in the very near future. And I think something everyone's going crazy about, there's going to be women wrestling men throughout the area for the very first time in Southeastern wrestling history. Women's liberation comes to professional wrestling.
That should be something to see indeed. And I think Ken Lucas has the attention of Jimmy Golden.
I believe that's correct. And of course, today on the program we saw Paul Orndorff, a very tough competitor. And you know what I think the thing we should mention is at the top of the program, Ron Fuller said he would not be back to the area. And again, I would like to reiterate and say that I don't believe it's anything to do with running or being afraid. It's just the fact that mentally he has been abused. He's got a few things to figure out. His family, basically, when it comes to the Fullers and Golden, and that's something that's hard to handle. It's hard to swallow. Ron's going to clear his head, and I'm sure that someplace down the line, he's going to see the Tennessee set once again.
Hopefully so. I'm sorry that whole incident took place, but it's happened now, and all we can do is, with the comments of Ron Fuller, wish him the best of luck in his endeavors.
World champion Harley Race will be here in 6 to 8 weeks, Charlie.